Hi friends, welcome back to CADable. This is Engineer Ibrahim Omer, and in this tutorial we'll make this block in AutoCAD. I'm using AutoCAD 2018 and this would be practice exercise 7 of this playlist, and I will use this drawing to create this part. Okay, I have already created this, so I'll go to here new, and here I will select this template, let's say, and select open. So let's start this drawing, and first of all I will put off these grids, and in AutoCAD by default we are in drafting mode. So first of all you should change your workspace setting from drafting and annotation to 3D modeling. Okay, so I will first make this base, and here you can see the dimensions are 118 by 44, and this thickness is 16, or the extrusion is 16 in the upward direction. So as you can see that currently we are in the top view, and basically we have to change this from, let's say, top view to southeast isometric. And remember, we are drawing this object in 3D in isometric. Okay, you can see this orientation box as well. So let's go to here my drawing, and I will start with this 118 by 44, this base. And let's say I will start with the rectangle command, and let's say this dimension is 118, then press tab, and then this dimension is 44. Okay, and here you can see your base. Next is I will use 16 millimeter extrusion in the upward direction. So I will use this command, press pull. You can use extrude command as well, but I think this command is easy in AutoCAD. Let's go to your press pull, and remember you should go inside the bounded area, not here. Okay, otherwise this press pull will not work. So just go to here inside the bounded area, and I will drag this to upward. Okay, and I will write 16. And now this 2D object is converted into 3D. Here you cannot see the 3D because currently we are in 2D wireframe. I have to change this visual style to, let's say, shades of gray. And now you can see that 3D object has been created. Next is I will draw this part, and here you can see that the diameter is 44, so I can make one circle having diameter 44, and I will place it here, and then we will trim the unnecessary parts. So let's say I'll go to here circle, and I will use this one center diameter, and I will make one circle having diameter 44 units, and I will select this circle, and I'll go to here move command. I will snap its quadrant, and I will snap it right in the center. Okay, right in the midpoint. Now I don't want this part and this part, so I'll go to press pull again, and this time I have to delete this part. So I'll go to this bounded region, inside bounded region, and I will drag here. Okay, downwards. Similarly, press pull inside the bounded region and downwards. Okay, now I don't want this rectangle, just delete it. Next is I will create the slot. In AutoCAD we don't have a direct slot command, but we have to use circle and rectangle to create slot. In SolidWorks you have slot commands directly. So the diameter of this circle is 16, so this circle is concentric with this arc. So let's say I will go to circle command again, circle with centered diameter, snap this point, and the diameter is 16. Okay, next is I will make this line. Basically this line is pitch, so I'll go to here line command, and remember I have to make straight lines, so check this box. So that I can make straight lines, orthogonal or 90 degree lines, straight lines. So this must be 24. Similarly, select this quadrant and I will write 24. Okay, and now I will join this to here. Next is I will copy this circle. So I'll select this circle, I'll go to a copy, and I will snap let's say the center point, and I will drag this to here. Okay, now we will delete this circle, we don't want. And well, if you are modeling in shades of gray or any 3D let's say 3D visual style, so you cannot pick these lines. So I think it's better to use 2D wireframe if you want to delete some lines. So select this one and press delete. Similarly, I don't want this, delete. Okay, let's change this to shades of gray again. Now I will use press pull command to create this slot. So just go to here, press pull. I will select this one to downwards, similarly this one to downwards, similarly this one to downwards. Now I will delete this circle, and I will delete this circle. Okay, I will delete this line as well, and okay, done. So next is we will create this part, and here you can see that the dimension is 48, and this vertical dimension is let's say 40 minus this 16 will give you 24, and this dimension is let's say 24. Okay, so 24 and 24 will give you 48. So basically you have to make this square of 48 by 48. We have to change this from southeast isometric to let's say front. Okay, so let's start with a let's say rectangle, and I will draw one rectangle having dimensions 48, tab 48. Okay, now I will just rotate it. Okay, I'll go to your press pull. I will extrude it up to 12, and now I will go to here, center with diameter. I will snap its center point, and I will make one circle having diameter 48, and I will delete this part and this part. I'll go to your press pull. I will go inside this bounded region, similarly here, and done. Now we can put this part onto this surface. So I will select all these. I'll go to here, move. I will select this vertex, and I will select this one. Okay, now we can go to front plane. Okay, now you can see that this dimension is 40 units. So let's go to your line command, and let's say I will draw one line having dimensions 40 units, and this must be right in the center. So I'll go to your center with diameter. I will snap this point, and I will make one circle having dimensions 20 units. You can see that this diameter is 20, and now we can delete this line. Okay, you cannot pick this in shades of gray, so I'll change it to 2D wireframe. Now you can pick this line, delete this line, and also delete this line, this circle. Now I will use orbit command, and now I can change this from 2D wireframe to shades of gray. Also, we want a cut extrusion here. I'll use press pull. I'll go inside this bounded region, and I will go this side. And now we can use copy command to copy this part onto here. You can use mirror command as well. Just go to here, copy, select this one, press enter key. And let's say I will select this vertex, and I will go to here, and I will use orbit command. I will select this time move command. I will select this vertex, and I will select this vertex. Now you can see that we have three solid bodies. Let's say one is here, another one is here, and another one is here. So basically we want this part as a single solid body. So we can use this command union. Okay, I will select all these, select enter, and now you can see that these three bodies are combined as a one single solid body. Now we can delete these lines and circles, and we have completed this exercise. I hope you like it, and if you have any questions, any queries related to this tutorial or any other tutorial in my list, you can ask in comment section. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to our channel for more informative and interesting projects. Thank you.